We're long enough. You are a bunch of fucking assholes. You know why? You don't have the guts to be what you want to be. You need people like me. You need people like me so you can point your fucking fingers and say, that's the bad guy. So, what I make you? Good? You're not good. You just know how to hide, how to lie. Me, I don't have that problem. Me, I always tell the truth, even when I lie. So say goodnight to the bad guy. The last time you're gonna see a bad guy like this again, let me tell you.
Buddies, it's the Ron and Fez show. I'm Ron. There's Fez.
Oh, sure.
Oh, no, not again. Not again today. I do not want to put up with Fez 2000, the soundboard Fez. 866-RON-0-FEZ, 866-RON-0-FEZ. That means bad news. I got to talk more to you, Earl. I got to talk more to you, Dave.
That's good news for us, because we like talking to you.
Yeah, but you're the two knuckleheads of the show.
Oh.
And supposedly, I'm supposed to sit back here with my is-he-or-isn't-he pal. We both make fun of you two guys, and then we cash a check. But now my is-he-or-isn't-he pal, the new thing now is he ever coming back to work? That's where it is. He's been on some kind of a contract holdout now. We're in day four. I'm going to finally pull the curtain back and announce the truth.
I don't think he is.
Fez is not happy about the merger, and he has decided to do... We are now the diner. We are now the Trellis Diner, where Fez has done a boycott of people that don't even know. We have no idea. That's what he's doing it.
You got it.
Stay out of the soundboard, Fez. Seriously. I no longer like you. So I don't know whether we're going to hear from him or not. And I asked him today, Because he's like, so what do they think? And I'm like, Fez, no one knows. Apparently people think you have a head cold. So according to him, this is his fourth day out now. He's never even so much as heard from Wiki. I don't know what happened, Earl, what you did to our relationship with Wiki, but it seems to be that shit's been shot to the sky, is all I'll say.
Okay. That can't be good, then.
This is your way of jumping in and you're trying to act like a person?
Yeah, well, no, I'm just saying. Anytime you shoot that shit to the sky,
watch
out.
You know who you remind me of, in all honesty?
Who?
Tory Ryder. If I had to compare you to anybody in the business right now, it would be Tory Ryder. Daryl. Daryl, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Good morning, Ronnie. Are we going to bury Fez in Northern Virginia?
I will, even if he's alive. I'm at the point right now that I'm literally ready to bury him, scratching at his own box, so to speak. What I want you to do, Dave, is all the things with Big A that you'd claim you'd do yesterday. That's where it would make me happy.
Okay, bring the man in. Andrew, if you're riding around that van of yours.
What is he doing?
Come on out. He rides around the van.
You know what's really funny? I notice when Fez isn't here and you feel like a little more responsible, you don't even know how to sit. You have a whole... You sit like a bad newsman.
Yeah. It's such a bad Letterman ripoff where
what are you doing?
I'm pounding index cards.
Every other day, you're the normal wacky Dave.
Yeah, right.
But Fez doesn't show up and all of a sudden you're like a stepmom. It's just ridiculous.
I gotta push buttons. I don't know. I feel
you push one button on. Mike's on. On, and at the end of the break, it's mic off. And for some reason, you feel like it's NASA. Stop fucking worrying.
All right.
Although, you know, with Fez out, we did get a lot of cards and letters sent in to him, which I had no idea people felt this way about. So, give me like a little soft music in the background if you want to push a button, Dave. Let's see. That's actually not bad. Smoother than Fez pulls it off. And much smoother than Earl does, because Earl, I noticed you're zero help today.
I'm through the
thing. You know what? The glow of Friday's show is off, my friend. You are back to be, you're back to being Earl. And I hate it, and you're on secret report. All right, here's some of the things that were sent in to about Fez Whatley, which is great. Ron and Fez show sounds much better without Fez Whatley, much less faggy. Happy typing girl wrote that. That one shocked me.
She does have a keen ear for radio.
I had no idea.
Yeah, I think her...
much less faggy. I almost find that offensive. Right, run a Fez. Since Fez has been out, I say fuck him. Fuck him in the ear. Love Melinda. Wow. Some of these things are a little harsher than I thought.
Well, Fez refused to buy Melinda a drink on Friday. I think she's a little steamed about that.
Well, you don't know which Melinda it is. You don't have to say that right away.
Okay.
You don't have to point her out to the crowd, Mr. I don't know how to sit when Fez isn't here. What are you acting like you're riding the levels so hard?
I have to. Sometimes the strings come in, and it's really loud.
You literally... Earl, tell me the truth. He hits a button, and he's looking... Now he's got his thumb just on the level constantly.
Listen to these strings.
What are you doing? Are you fucking mixing a new thing? You mixing Wilco's new album?
Listen to these strings. Will they tone it down a little?
Hey, Hector, you're in Ron and Fez.
Hey, what up, fellas?
Yeah.
Yesterday, I listened to the whole show in my shop, and I was kind of distracted, and believe it or not, I didn't even notice Fez was gone until barely this morning.
Yeah.
I guess you don't need him.
Yeah, we really... that's what this one seems to say. You don't need him. Love Mikey Boy. Wow. I'm most uncomfortable with Mikey Boy writing love. Why are we only getting letters from people we know?
Well, they have the address.
Here's one. Now I'm sick. Fez must be a carrier. He got me sick Friday night. Tracy. Why doesn't she write love? Why only do some people write love and others just say their names? How do you sign off in an email? Do you
Your pal.
What are you, a 12-year-old? Your pal. John, you're on a Fez.
Hey, can't you just dope him up with some I-57, like a racehorse, and get him in there to work?
Hey, Stink Bomb, do you know that you are banned for life from the Hard Rock? A lifetime ban from the Hard Rock.
It's about time.
Yeah.
He should be banned from New York City.
Here's Joe. Joe, you're on a Fez.
Hey, Ronnie, I just wanted to know how many cocks Fez he has in his ass.
I'm not even sure.
There's 7 dicks in my ass, and there's always room for 8.
Oh. Dicks. What about the cocks?
It's cock time.
I don't even know what that has to do with it. All this was much funnier yesterday, but it was much less annoying. Because I talked to him this morning, he's like this. Yeah, I don't think I'm ready to come back in today. Still feeling a little ill. Please let Elo know. And I go, he doesn't even know that you're not here. He has no idea at all. What's up with you today, David? Don't start and act like you're reading the news. That is not going to fucking happen.
Nothing.
It's already annoying enough when Fez does it, when Fez turns newsman. But if you're going to try it, I'll really go nuts.
I'm doing good, Mr. B. You know, problems at home. I'm doing good, though.
What's the big problem? Still the check?
It's kaput.
What happened last night?
I just don't know. No, she just refuses to. She doesn't like me talking on the radio, even on the XM side.
Yeah.
And I thought I could get away with that, because I didn't think she would actually listen to her MiFi.
She
and
listened yesterday?
She did. She listened yesterday.
Are you swearing to God now?
Yeah, I am swearing to God.
On the new bones? So she heard you talking and us getting lining up new chicks for you?
Yeah, that's what she heard.
Yeah.
And I'm saying, well, you know, you don't seem to be happy with me, so.
Really?
Big deal, yeah. I need to get, you know, after my head shaved and everything on Tuesday. That will be the
kicker.
Yeah,
Josh, you're on Fez.
Hey guys, isn't the Midnight Rider supposed to be in today?
Yeah, he was supposed to be in, but I couldn't bear that, so I called him this morning and told him to wait till Fez comes back. Which, let's face it, Fez is his buddy, and basically tried to rig it the other night so the Rider would beat Eastside Dave.
Right, and just all the shenanigans, enough's enough.
Yeah.
Me and Mr. B at least play an honest game.
Right.
We play a fair game. And that's what we're playing here today. We're playing a non-Fez, non-Rider Mr. B and Dave show.
And here's the thing. You know, the Rider tried to attack me the other night at the gig, and luckily
what the fuck?
I ran like Bobby Heenan to get out of there. Robert, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
I guess I've got a question. I've been listening to the show for about 6 months, and I don't get the joke. Who's this character, Fez?
Well, Fez is one of the guys that fakes sick at XM. And I don't know what the whole gimmick is. Earl, tell me the truth. Do you honestly believe Fez is sick?
I don't think so now. I mean, I know that first day, maybe, but now he's kind of... Yeah. I think it sounds more like a holdout than a...
Apparently his lungs filled up with cum. And I don't even know how that could happen. I guess it went down the wrong pipe. But that's what bronchitis is. I looked it up, and it's a heavy cold, and then your lungs fill up with cum.
Jeez. Elton John probably gets bronchitis a lot.
Why are you going to attack Elton John? Yeah. All right? Yeah. Sir Elton John, from now on, I don't want you to talk about any nights unless you use the term sir. Brad, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ronnie.
Yeah.
Hey, Soundboard Fez.
Yes.
I was going to get your take on that Lost episode last night. Don't you think it's kind of wacky?
Wait. Hold on. I got to tell you the truth. I have it TiVo'd, but I haven't watched yet, so I will cut you off. I have not seen the Lost from last night. What about you, Dave? Did you say it?
Yes, I did. I liked it.
All right, don't bring it up to me. I just said I haven't seen it.
All right.
Even Soundboard Fez wouldn't do that.
This is not a soundboard.
Hmm. You won't be disappointed.
Who says I'm... How could a TV show disappoint me? I haven't made a purchase. I get it for free, and now I'm able to fast-forward through all the spots. So basically, I'm living a whole new life out there. Just a fantastic life.
But it's taking up your valuable time. I mean, time is money. So goes the phrase. And that's taking up...
I can't believe it's me and you having a conversation.
What?
I can't believe this is where my career is. That I'm sitting down here with you.
I'm trying to converse with you.
Yeah, not going to happen. This wouldn't happen in real life. You and I would never have a discussion.
Maybe if we bumped on the corner or something, I saw you.
What does that mean? Bumped uglies? I don't know. I'm not gay. I heard you and Big A in here yesterday, and I was disgusted. Dan, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Ron. Hey, man, guys, love the show.
Yeah, it's fantastic. I was done for... Oh, I wasn't. He's not
but
here.
But I do have to say... Ron?
Yeah.
You there? Hey, but I do have to say, I kind of miss Fez. I love the show. Mm-hmm. But you really got to find somebody other than fucking Dave, man.
I know. It is a problem. There's no bench on this team, let's face it.
Well, get Earl in there.
Earl,
get Earl on there.
Went into a panic. I tried to get Earl to talk with me yesterday. Wouldn't do it. We're 15 minutes into the show today, and all I see Earl doing is leaning towards his microphone. Leaning towards the microphone. And I got to tell you this. Earl, as you know, I had personal business yesterday. So he was out of here at 3 o'clock. We didn't see him again until 10 minutes to 6. So I say to him, man, thank God you made it. We're already down Fez. You don't show up to the last minute. So he's going over to me, and he says it got so late in this meeting that he says that he was looked at his watch, and then he stood up and said, I'm sorry, folks. I got to go be funny. And he said that without the slightest bit of irony. You honestly feel like, Earl, you bring the funny.
No, I didn't say I had to. I personally was bringing the funny.
You told me, this is the fucking quote, I got to go be funny.
Yes, that was the direct quote. You were absolutely correct in that.
So why didn't you tell the truth? I got to go hit an on button and let fucking Ron swim upstream for 3 hours.
Well, it wouldn't have had that effect, I guess, but I don't know.
You get to lie to strangers. That's the whole point of it. And this is you interacting with me, right? This is it? This is our repartee right now going on?
No, you asked me a question, and I'm trying to answer it as best as I can.
Is this the funny you're bringing? I just want to know, is this the funny stuff? Because I'll be happy if it is. You know who I want to start working with when Fez is out is those two guys in Connecticut that O and A are battling with. They seem like they're on to something. I wouldn't mind swinging them in here for a little bit.
They got a good vibe. Mr. B, I was going to say, as a solution, yeah. I'd like, for this week, I'd like to give you a portion of my paycheck. I really would.
Really?
Yeah, that's what I'm willing
How
to
much?
Do. Because it just dawned on me that you are swimming up the stream.
How much?
50% of this week's paycheck.
Earl, what about you?
I'll give you 50.
And I'd like to get 100% of Fez's. Because what bugs me is not so much that he's faking, and he is fucking faking, and the bastard is listening to his radio right now, and he didn't pick up yesterday, and I don't see him picking up so far today. And I want that, between that, that's 100% of a real paycheck, and 250% of fake paychecks. You know what it would be like if you guys gave me 50% of your paycheck?
What's that?
It's like when some little kid finds out the dad got fired and tries to bring him a piggy bank. Like, here, maybe this will help. And you just want to take that piggy bank and smash it over the baby's face and say, your money's worthless to me. It's change.
It's good for a cup of coffee. It's good for something.
Mm. Deanna, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, remember last week you said that you wanted a whole day with Dave. You didn't want Fez to come in. So
well,
I guess
you know what?
God, you should be careful
no,
what you wish for.
Here's the thing, Deanna. I don't think it's up. If you think God made Fez's lungs fall up with cum to get even with me, maybe he did. But I will say this, and this is just between me and you, Deanna.
Okay.
Sometimes I say things just to see how Fez will react. And that's the only reason I say it. I just want him to. I don't want him overly confident.
So do you think maybe
I don't want him running
to do a lesson?
Huh?
It's not about.
Don't you think if God wanted to teach me a lesson, he would have destroyed my lungs instead of Fez's?
Maybe Fez is trying to teach you a lesson to show you that you need him.
You think that's why he made himself sick?
It could be.
What is that disease called when you try to make your baby sick?
It is...
Something by...
Munchausen by syndrome or something
by
like
syndrome.
That. By proxy.
Yeah.
Something like that. Some weird thing where you take your kids to the hospital.
All right, Deanna, I got to get back on, so go back to pole dance. But thanks for the call, all right, honey?
Hey, don't be mean to me.
What did I say? I said nothing wrong.
It is true. I was dancing it, but still.
I could tell. I know the raspy voice girl.
By my voice.
I know raspy voice girls tend to be dancers. And anyone who listens to us tends to be a dancer, so thanks. 866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. So things might be over with you and your chick?
Yeah.
Why don't you do this?
Uh-huh.
Because you've never done it before in your life?
Okay.
You need the bad affair with a dancer.
Oh, yes.
Every guy should have at least one long bad affair with a dancer.
And I've always tried.
Yeah.
Just cannot seal the deal with them.
Yeah. So you... Really?
Yeah.
You seal the deal with money. But then you think that you're in a relationship with them, and then later you found out she blew 8 guys at a fucking party, and yet you still nail her after the argument. There's no way to get out of that. But I think only Bronx Johnny's been in it. Johnny, you've dated a dancer, right?
Yeah, man. She was from Cleveland.
Yeah, and how'd it go?
It went really bad. Some dude picked up the phone talking about he was daddy and shit, so that was the end of that.
Black guy?
I think so. He sounded kind of black.
Sure. They all do. Everyone in your generation does. Yeah, it is a good thing for you to get into. Now, if you really look at this, are you a little nervous you won't get a check after you're done with this check?
No. Mr. B, I turned a whole new corner. You know, I feel good about myself these days. I don't know. After my victory on Friday in the wrestling match where, I mean, people saw me kick ass.
I know Solera called you yesterday.
Yeah, she did.
And tried to talk you out of it.
Yeah, she yelled at me.
Yeah.
She yelled at me like a mother and said, you know, I'm an idiot for making this decision. But it's a decision that has to be made. I feel good about myself.
And all because you got some applause.
That's right. Well, Mr. B.
And then you had the attention of the beautiful Casey Elon.
Right. She's just wonderful. But no, I mean, no, but we're pals. That's what that story is. But
have you jacked off thinking about her?
I cannot comment about that.
Yeah.
She could be listening. But I'm not going to make the same mistakes that I made with Westside. But when you hear 800 people in Times Square, Ron Fez on Broadway, chanting Eastside Dave, you so handsome, it turns your life around. I feel...
Most of those people were guys.
Oh.
Okay.
Shit.
Before you. And there again was a sense of irony. They were having fun.
Really?
Yeah. And basically, they chant at you, and these are the same people who go to midnight screenings and yell shit out of Frankenfurter. So don't be overly feeling good about yourself.
Okay.
Here's Jeff. Jeff, you're on Fez.
Hey, Dave, you've always kicked ass on this show. You're my favorite guy on this show, and Fez sucks.
All right, here's the new person you can start dating, right?
I don't know. Wait a second. Fez, Mr. Watley is fantastic, even if he is pulling this strike gimmick.
Et tu, Brute? You're now stabbing Fezzy in his back?
Someone's got to be a scab.
All right.
It happened in 95-4 in baseball. It's going to happen now.
95-4?
It was 94 and then 5 or something. I don't know.
Jason, you're on Fez.
Roddy.
Yeah.
Listen, Fez is losing his commitment to this show here. Why don't you sit down at the round table with Elo and Opie and see if you can trade off Fez for Anthony Cumia and have a real radio show?
That would be a real radio show, but Opie's the one who found him. So Opie goes on to have a fantastic life. Who knows? If I would have found him, who knows where my life would be right now? Sure as fuck wouldn't be sitting across from Eastside Dave. I'll tell you that.
You'd be in a jet. I could just picture a lot of private jets for Mr. B.
Why are you trying to play up to me? It's something I do not like.
I'm not, but what I am...
You think I want to sit here and play fantasy with you?
No!
I want to shut my eyes and let you paint a picture of my life?
Well, I am a descriptive person.
Yeah. Here's Eric. Eric, you're on Fez.
Yeah, hey, Ron, I'm thinking that instead of Eastside Dave across you, I think Bronx Johnny would be great for second mic. He's witty, he's intelligent, he knows what he's talking about. Unlike Dave, who,
My only problem with Bronx Johnny is he's not a guy that I would call chatty. He's not a chatter at all.
Yeah.
And he likes to be laid back, take it easy, a man of few words, which may work great if you're trying to survive in the Bronx. But radio, let's see you just go on a monologue for a second. Let's see you go into one of your tears, Johnny. We'll let you have some time at the mic. Ready? Rock it.
Quick question. What's a monologue? I don't want to just go into some shit and I don't know what I'm talking about.
All right, there you go. That's 4 seconds he gave me. That's 4 seconds.
You telling me to do a monologue? I don't even know what that is. It's like that.
You graduated from college, right?
I never had to do that, though. Is that like that vagina thing where they talk about vaginas and stuff?
Yeah, go ahead. Why don't, for the next couple of minutes, you talk about vaginas? And go, Bronx Johnny.
Vaginas are nice. Sometimes they're juicy, sometimes they're dry. You got to work on it a little bit. Work your fingers, work your tongue, do something with them. They're good sometimes.
That was 8.5 seconds.
I did what I could.
If anything, it would be the vagina quip. Now, by the way, could anyone be less sexy than Johnny? Sometimes they're juicy, sometimes you got to work them a little bit. You know, with the tongue or the fingers. What are you doing? You're fucking... You're talking about eating a fucking bushel of clams.
Sort of, that's what
I guess it is.
Kind of. It's like a taco thing. That's what you do. Sometimes you got to play with your taco a little bit.
What are you doing? You trying to get your taco off?
A little bit.
Why?
It's good.
By the way, this kid eats tacos 3 meals a day. No, see, I love him. I love him like there's no tomorrow, but I'm only going to get anywhere from 4 to 8 seconds out of him.
And he's trying to put on weight for his security job, too.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Well, it's coming along gangbusters, Johnny. Congratulations.
Yeah, I got to get some get some beef on the kid. They don't like when you're too small by the door.
Yeah.
It doesn't apparently do enough intimidating for your job. You have to look beefy, I guess.
Again, I love you, Johnny, but you're 4'10". If anything...
5'4".
You need to put on some height. And weight isn't your problem. You're a fucking doorstop already. You need to grow a little bit if you really want to be intimidating. At 5'4", the only way they're going to be intimidated by you is with a gun.
I got that, too. They don't let me bring that in, but worst come to worst.
What do you keep at home?
A little revolver, .38.
I can see you with a little Derringer, like a little girl's gun. just something with one shot in it. You a gun guy at all, Dave?
BB guns, yeah. I applied.
Everything is 12 years old with you, isn't
it? No, I applied. I've applied for a real gun, but I have a record.
Did you mark David Chapman? What's your record?
I've been arrested 3 times.
What are the 3? I didn't know. I knew about the 1. Are you pissed?
18 years old, I tried to buy beer, and the guy, he was a cop behind the counter, and he was in plain clothes, and he says, can I give me your driver's license? Because you need to be 21 when you're in Jersey. And I said, I don't have it with me. So then he asked for my social security number, and I gave him my actual social security number. He looked up, found out that I was underage, arrest number 1. Arrest number 2, I was living in an apartment, and I refused to pay this plumbing bill because my toilet was always backed up. And I'm like, fuck this, I'm not going to pay it anymore. The landlord deserves to pay it. And so the plumber reported me to the cops.
Yeah, but that's not, you haven't stolen, you're in small claims court.
The cops came to my apartment and arrested me.
Well, what did you do when they showed up? You must have been like a maniac.
Yeah, I was saying, you can't touch me, you can't come in here, you can't do anything to me. The landlord is responsible for my toilet being backed up every second fucking day.
Why do your turds got to be the size of fucking poodles? That's the big problem. Why don't you break him up with a stick before you flush?
Was it like a scene out of Cops? You were in like this wife beater and you're just like, you're not going to take me.
No, it wasn't a scene out of Cops. He's white.
Hey.
Earl, anything with you, you laying under a kiddie pool would be a scene out of fucking Cops.
Not all the guys who were arrested were black, which is most of them.
They're fucking black or they're hayseeds, which in my fucking family we consider black. Not you people listening. The other hayseeds, your neighbors. People who look and act just like you, but don't own an XM radios. They're the ones I don't like.
Right, and then the 3rd time was me banging my chick in the back of my Toyota Corolla at Sandy Hook, New Jersey.
Everything about you is low rent. Every fucking thing you described to me is low rent.
It was romantic. I don't see it as low rent. There was no place to go. You see it in American Graffiti and all these movies.
Teen movies. You're fucking 29 years old.
I wasn't last year.
You were 28 last year.
It happened when I was 24. It happened 5 years ago.
Okay.
And there was no place
when
else
I was
to go.
24, I had 2 houses. Whatever. I'm not going to get into a big thing about it.
So because of those 3 arrests, they will not let me have a gun.
I disagree.
I've tried.
None of those things are felonies. How could you not have a gun?
They won't let it.
Well, why don't you just go in the fucking market and get yourself a gun, if you know what I'm saying? Oh. I'll have Johnny pick you up something.
Okay.
And I want you to sit at home and play with it at night and think about your life until finally you put it up to your forehead and pull the trigger.
Oh, I'm not.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to fucking download you some Eastside Dave shows, put it on your fucking headphones and put a gun in your hand, and then we're going to bet before how long you shoot yourself in the head.
Hey, that bet will be never. When I hear Eastside Dave, I'm elated.
It's your buddy Stryker, the fucking Daily Stryker. What can we do for you, Stryke?
Hey there, buddy.
Yeah, what's up?
Dave, you know, you're complaining because Westside's listening to her MiFi, and, you know, if you remember directly, it's your fault that she has the MiFi, and it's your fault that she's hearing this stuff.
This time I don't think you're unhappy about it, though. This time it seems like you're trying to push it.
Yeah, a little bit.
Like Johnny Staccato. Push it, Johnny, push it.
Enough's enough, Mr. B. You know, a man can only take so much. And right now I've had
that's bullshit. The only thing that happened is you had some positive feedback in your life.
All right, that's
this girl's
true.
Done nothing except for a beautiful woman was nice to you, and people clapped and chanted your name, and then when you went to a Looney's, they clapped for you.
That's, okay, that's a big part of it, but not
you
the only part.
You think you're Jackie Gleason. You honestly think you're the fucking great one.
I'm entitled to some happiness, not to, after two radio shows, get home and then have to defend myself for an hour.
That I can't believe. That I agree with you.
That's what I fucking do for the last 3 months. People think it's just because of the last couple weeks where things have been good.
Right.
It's been 3 months after doing these two shows. I have to get home. No, I didn't mean that. No, it's not that big of a deal. Please. No, don't cry.
She starts crying.
Do this every fucking day for 2 months?
No, I couldn't do it for one day. I couldn't do it for a minute.
That's what I'm living with. It's got nothing to do, honestly, it has nothing to do with outside
if
stuff.
If I heard that when I came home, I'd wake my kids up for that beating. And I'm what you would consider, you know, a feminist. But I still don't want to take any fucking shit.
Right.
I'll fucking break a thumb in front of the children.
Yeah.
All right, so go back to your story.
Well, no, I mean...
So every night you go home, you got to hear it.
I got to hear it, yeah. And I'm not... I won't personally hit
now,
her, but...
Are you sure... Well, you'll pay someone. But are you sure every single night she bitches at you or just...
Yes.
It happens occasionally and you're
yes.
saying every...
When... Okay.
Give me other things.
100% of the time when she listens to the show,
right.
There's a problem. It's...
Give me some of the things that piss her off.
Talking about the dog or the thing. Why,
well, you got
why?
Blown by a dog.
Okay.
That happened.
That...
So what?
Just the reverse. No,
you blew a dog.
No. Right.
Doesn't matter.
Whatever.
Whatever it was, both of you came in each other's
past
mouth.
Is the past.
Right.
Secondly, the whole chef cock thing has just totally, you know, that continues to surface.
But it didn't. I haven't brought it up. No one on the show's brought it up.
I know, but when a caller does, she feels like it's my fault.
That's wrong, though.
I know.
You can't control the callers. And two, you and the callers never blew a chef. It happened.
Right.
Who cares?
Right.
I don't care. I don't judge by it.
We're innocent in this. In fact, she even gave me a mandate. A mandate if things not
a mandate is what you and Big A have fucking planned.
Right.
And for, what was it, $45? You would let him bone you in the ass?
Yeah.
Which, by the way, he doesn't even want to do.
Right.
So we'll have to get somebody else.
But it's, you know, it's all this stuff. And, I mean, it's having to live by
all right,
a
let's
fucking
hear.
Manifesto.
Is that true? Did she type it up for you?
It's true.
She typed it up?
I typed it up.
What did she do?
She made me handwrite it and then type it up.
You fucking lied to me.
I'm not lying. Where's the Bible? Because
I'll swear
on it right now.
Get the Bible. Rush it in here immediately.
Where is the Bible? Because I'm sick of it. And that's those are the things that happens.
Wait a minute. What kind of notes is he getting during the show? Why are people handing him notes? Look at her run out of here. She's petrified to end up on the air.
Notes that don't make any sense right now with this conversation. But anyway, she made a mandate.
Yeah.
That is 10-point long, a 10-point mandate.
All right.
Number one, and this is from her words.
And let's put your hand on the Bible that this is true.
You see it right there.
It's the right hand on the Bible.
Right hand on the Bible.
I'm shocked by this.
Well, number one.
I think we discussed it, but you never went through it, right?
Never talked about it on over here.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so number one, no talk of chef cock.
She said chef cock?
She said that to me. And she said, no talk of chef cock.
All right, now let me go for you, Earl. Earl, could you put up with this?
I would have been out the door so fast.
What about just number one? It doesn't seem like a bad idea. Don't talk about the chef cock. I don't think I have a problem with that one if I was her. You probably shouldn't have done that in the first place.
All right. I got no problem with that. Number two, no talk of getting fingered by a chef or fingering the chef.
So she doesn't even believe, she feels like she's got to go in deep, so to speak,
right.
To go through everything that could happen.
Ron, remember, this is an exact quote, and as I've analyzed this for the past couple weeks, no talk of getting fingered by a chef, ... or fingering the chef?
Right. She had her finger up.
She never told me she put her finger up that guy's ass. And I am fucking furious. I've been lied to.
Yeah.
I can't believe she made me write this on the mandate.
Well, while she was blowing him, she probably had his finger up.
Right. That's terrible. I didn't know about that.
Some guys are into that.
It's amazing.
Foundry Music Jeff loves it. For me, I see you fucking around down there, I'm going to fucking break something. Take your finger out of my ass, honey.
Absolutely.
I'm not fucking playing games with
right.
you. Because you let that go, and the next thing I'm putting on the strap on,
yeah.
and you've got on false eyelashes.
Right.
And it shouldn't happen. All right, so she had her finger up Chef's ass.
Yeah, and that's a real big surprise. And it's taken me a few weeks of analyzing.
But I'm sure it wasn't her idea. I'm sure while she was sucking on his cock, he just grabbed her finger and started shoving into his ass.
That makes it worse.
Why?
Because it means she's not even in control of herself. She's a fucking wild thing.
All right, hold on. I think it's wild thing. I think I love you. It was where I would go if I was producing. Earl, let me ask you this. Would you be more offended if your girlfriend was blowing a chef or had a finger up his ass?
The finger up the ass.
Worse than having a dick in the mouth?
I mean, but that's a lot. I mean, you know, fellatio is a lot more commonplace. You know, ramming fingers up, you know, where.
But I mean, this
shit.
Is in her mouth that you fucking kiss.
What?
So what? I shake her hands. She.
She's fucking. You. She didn't leave. Come home and rub a fucking shit stinker right. on your finger under your nose.
So for the rest of my life, when she gives me a handy.
Yeah.
Basically, I have chef ass on my cock.
Maybe.
I mean, I don't want to get graphic here, folks. Thank God it's XM.
Too late.
Because that's what I feel like.
All right, so that's bummed you out. Not so much that she said, don't bring up about me fingering a chef, but the fact that...
She deceived
you
me.
Think that's what she means? You think that's what Wild Thing means?
Yeah, I think Wild Thing, absolutely. West Side Wild Thing, huh? I think that's exactly what she means. Exactly.
Wild Thing. Here she comes.
Wild Thing, I think I love you. But I wanna know for sure.
Alright, so that's two.
Right.
Now, what's made you angrier, not so much you can't talk about it, because you didn't even know.
Right.
She had her finger up with a chef's ass.
Didn't know. I didn't know. So I was deceived.
Alright.
Number three on the West Side mandate, don't say to Ron Fez that West Side doesn't like him. It's not true.
It is true, though, right?
It is, because you know what? Where was she on Friday at the big-ass bash?
I didn't see her.
She wasn't there. Wasn't there to say hi to Ronnie B, who was behind my corner since I got fired.
Mm-hmm.
She wasn't there to even say hi to, you know, her nemesis, Fez.
Now, you know we would have fucking brought her out on stage, let everybody chant Chef Cock, though. So you got to see from her point of view.
Right. Well, hey.
No, she had off that night? Or she had to work?
She had off.
So she did not want to see you in the ring?
Nope. And this is what... And then Solera's yelling me about stuff. I brought this in and floored her. Like an anchor flowing of, you know, a bottom-dwelling ocean creature.
All right, hold on. So you turn off Wild Thing. Fucking 2 seconds, please. So you're honestly now calling Solera a bottom-dwelling ocean creature that had an anchor dropped on her.
No, I'm not calling Solera.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I guess I am. Yeah.
But she's not.
Yeah, she got floored.
Cigar Sid, how you doing, buddy?
Pretty good. How's it going? Listen, Dave, West Side having her finger up the chef's ass is nowhere near as bad as her blowing him.
I got to agree with Sid here.
Yeah, doctors go around all day putting their fingers up guys' asses.
True.
It's not like they're putting their cock in their mouth.
I doubt
that's true.
Strongly.
What would you do? Would you let a doctor put his finger up your ass or his cock in your mouth? What would seem more offensive?
Probably the finger, but...
Yeah.
But wait a second.
Probably you'd rather get a cock in your mouth than a finger in your ass.
Finger. But I doubt... Then
if you're so comfortable with that, why not let a small dick in there?
Wait, doctors also use gloves and
maybe
they use
she did.
Lubricant.
Maybe she's in the kitchen doing this. Maybe she put on a fucking dishwasher
she
glove.
She doesn't have ready-made medical supplies like that, Mr. B. I know West Side Wild Thing very well.
Yeah.
She doesn't have those type of things. She went barehanded up the ass. And
maybe
you know,
it could have been a doorknob.
Would you feel better if it was a thumb?
I would have felt a little better.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, thumbs are the poor man's finger. But no, she had to just go all the way up
so
there.
So poor men don't have fingers at all. They have 10 thumbs.
That's what I'm saying.
You're wrong. All right, Sid, I agree with you, but Eastside has to be judge and jury. This is his life.
It's my life, baby, just all as right. Billy Joel said it was.
Your hands on the Bible. All this, you swear to God, is true as a Catholic former altar boy.
Swear to God.
Now, I got to tell you the truth. I've been in some loony fucking relationships, and I never got a mandate.
Never got a contract?
No.
Yeah. I know. And the fact that I had to, she gave it to me, I had to write it down, and then she made me type it out.
Yeah.
Because she wanted me to remember it.
Dave, let's go to Dean. Dean, you're on Ron and Fez.
What's up, buddies?
Yeah.
Miss Fezzy. Dave, I just have to know, has Westside ever stuck her finger up your ass? Because if she hasn't, then it is 10 times worse that she did it to the chef and not you.
Finger up your ass, Dave?
No. And thank you, Dean. Thank you, brother, for pointing that out. She never put it up.
Did you want her to?
No, I don't really. But still, no offer.
Yeah.
Nothing.
She broke her finger, Cherry, with somebody other than you.
Yes, that's right. She did the finger, Cherry. And I mean...
So the other thing is she said, stop saying that. What are you mad at?
Bitch! Fuck this shit! Every fucking woman, I fucking welcome any broad in America to talk to me.
It ain't gonna happen. You aren't gonna be alone again.
I'm not! I got leads, Mr. B.
Who?
I'm not saying on the radio.
The one I gave you?
Yes.
Who's the leader right now? Casey Elon or the one I gave you?
She's a pal. She is a buddy who I'm
talking
to.
So the one I gave you is the one that you're really thinking about dating?
I guess so. I.
You're nervous. You're shy and you're nervous.
Yes, I am.
All right. Don't worry about a thing. All right. Go on. So you think she does hate me and Fez?
Yes, she does. She does.
Despises us.
Yeah, I'll say that. Okay. Even though she writes in the mandate that she doesn't.
She just doesn't want to be known for that.
Right.
But she's happy Fez is sick.
Oh,
she's ecstatic.
God, I guarantee you she's doing cartwheels right now.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. I believe even she has been like...
Is she doing that just because the show's better without him?
I don't know.
Okay.
I can't ask her that.
Huh. I'm going to say that to Fez. All right, let's go on.
Number 4 of the mandate is don't talk about Westside being stupid. Mm. That was kind of aimed at Fez, but then I learned aimed at me as well.
Now, yeah, Fez thinks that she's stupid.
Right.
He called her stupid at the ice cream recital that we were at. Which, by the way, we're all men. Let's stop eating ice cream.
No. No. I love it.
No.
I won't. But she, you know, I guess I've mentioned on the air how she sucks at directions.
Yeah.
MapQuest could give her the most perfect thing, and she will get lost in her own fucking backyard.
And you were also very dismissive. Like, whenever we were all together, when she would start talking, you would always go, yeah, that's right. That's, you know, you would always...
Yeah, you thought she was retarded. You used to always try to get her to stop talking to me.
Because her points, they're not valid, usually.
Mm-hmm.
They're kind of dim-witted. And I know that's me saying that, but trust me, people.
All right. I don't think so. I'm going to disagree there.
All right.
But you shouldn't call another person stupid unless you're a fucking idiot, Dave. And you are.
Yeah.
You're a fucking moron.
Okay.
All right, go ahead. Where are we right now?
Number 5 is don't speculate how Westside got her master's in teaching because of her low IQ, which she doesn't have. That's more of the stupid stuff.
And that's back at Fez.
Right.
Because Fez said, I don't know how she got a master's.
How did you get a master's in teaching, is what he said. So, by the way, I'd like to thank Mr. W, sitting there in sick bed for ruining my relationship, along with Whackbag.
He's down on sick bay, is where he is. What are you pointing at, Earl?
I was trying to get Dave's attention to something.
What do you want? Say it. Get his attention with words.
No, I was just then to check the monitor right next to him to his right.
Check the monitor.
Monitor's fine, man. We're not hitting any levels.
No, okay, because I didn't know if he had a problem with the names coming up. That's all.
Oh, the call screen. He's not even saying the right words for the things. The monitor is the levels, the call screen.
All right. Where are we right now? Now, if you can't explain yourself with words, how are you going to do it with your fucking hands, you maroon?
Number 5 is don't talk of Westside and Dave getting arrested for giving handies to each other.
Well, that you probably.
That's
should.
What.
And that's all you were doing, giving each other handies? You say it's romantic, but you weren't even fucking?
I could say something real. Okay. She was maybe not. Her cherry hadn't been broken at that point. And so.
2 years ago?
5 years ago.
Okay.
And so then I tried, but then there was a little. It just wasn't happening. You know, she's a small girl.
Yeah.
And I figured, well, how about just some handies? In the back seat, and that's what happened. And the cops came and saw that.
So that was you attempting?
Yeah, that was attempting. I thought we could loosen up, and then maybe, you know, let's go in for the penetration. But didn't happen.
What
like
a special,
that.
Special night it was for her.
We had a glass of wine.
You're in the back of a fucking Toyota, working her over,
well,
and then cops show up.
Yeah, I hadn't got my apartment yet. Until what, 6 months ago? True. She said number six is tell Sam from O&A not to call West Side Chef Side. So thank you, Sam.
I didn't know Sam was doing that. That's very fucking funny, though.
Yeah, he's on the list.
All right, so he... Now, again, that's fucking... That she should break up with Sam. It's got nothing to do with you.
Right, I know. I said, don't you see the humor in that? And Sam, is, you know, he's a buddy of mine, but still, he's not responsible.
Now, did he ever do it to her face or just on the air?
No, he just said it to me. But I thought it was so funny that I go, one of my friends at work calls you Chef Side, and that I think that's pretty funny. And again, the slaps in my face, the tears, the this and the throwing things.
She slapped you in the face?
Yeah, once.
For what?
And then throwing things. It's usually a combo of crying with the tissues, then throwing the box of tissues when the tissues have gone. And I'm like, I'll fucking take any piece of cardboard. I've taken fucking bumps from 300-pound men. I can take a piece of cardboard.
Stop it. You took one fucking bump and you ran out of there and yelled, they're killing me. All right, so Sam shows up in your thing.
Yeah.
And you don't make a mandate, but don't fucking hit me anymore.
Right. I didn't say that, no. No, I just dealt with it. I felt like that's the way men should be.
I don't even understand you.
I figure chicks...
What man gets hit? A fucking womanly man, that's who gets hit.
I guess so. Yeah, I mean, I figure I can take the pain. I'm good with physical punishment.
You're a bottom.
Right.
You're a fucking bottom.
Yeah. Number seven, she said, again, I don't know why she brought this into it, stop overdosing on aspirin and Advils.
You take a lot of aspirin and Advil.
Yeah, I have headaches. So what?
You got a brain tumor.
How is this relevant to any discussion of our fucking relationship?
That's true.
And boy, did that piss me off. And again, she only needs, like, two aspirins because she weighs a buck 05.
Yeah. And plus, she doesn't want you to cure your headaches. Why do you think he has these fucking headaches? You're screaming at him all the time.
I know. Just let me take. I take at least eight aspirins. Let me take it. I don't think anyone in the history of the world has died from taking eight aspirins. I just don't think it's happened.
Yeah, I don't think it. Eight is a lot, though. I will say that. You do it once a day, eight?
Yeah.
The problem, your blood is going to be so thinned out, the moment she hits you with a fucking box, it'll kill you. Next time she slaps you with a fucking Kleenex box.
I'm willing to take that risk to get rid of the headaches. Number eight was, tell Fez I'm not mad at him and I still love him. And again, this is just a bold-faced lie. This is just fucking...
And some of this stuff is redundant.
It's all redundant!
Yeah.
And that's... This piece of paper demonstrates the last 2 months. I have the same conversation every single day. Mm-hmm. Every day I'm defending myself, saying it's just the radio. Just don't take it personally.
I could never deal with a fucking woman who said, here's what you should say on the radio and here's what you shouldn't. They are no friend of yours when they do that. It's fucking insane.
It's driving me nuts, man.
You've got to fill 6 hours a day. God knows what you're going to say in here. Lord knows. You fucking say things because you've got nothing else.
I have to speak, right? Otherwise, absolutely, it's not radio. It's just a fucking Echo sketch.
Either that, after that, you're fucking Bronx Johnny. No, boss, I do like that. And fucking 3 seconds goes by, and then he walks into the back room and starts smoking out the window. That's not being in radio. Being radio is staying on the air when you've got nothing to say, like we are right now.
Exactly. Number nine.
So she does hate Fez, and he comes up. And she has every reason to hate him, because he calls her stupid and thinks she cheated to get a master's degree.
Right. And also thinks she's mousy.
Yeah,
is another comment.
Mousy is kind of a good thing.
Not really. Implies she has rodent-like features.
Yeah, like banging a little mouse. Who hasn't thought about that?
Well, I don't know. Number nine was tell Ron that I want to go to the museum with him still.
No fucking way. That will never happen.
I'm glad you're sticking to your guns. Hey.
I'll take you anywhere. It's going to be the fucking Tinicum Swamps right across from the Philadelphia airport.
That's right.
Where we used to drop them off.
And I just want to say, you missed your shot with Mr. B.
Yeah.
She almost ruined our relationship, right, Mr. B. Because I thought you were mad at me for not going to the museum. It was all her fault because she was mad at you.
All right, hold on. Here's Sam, the man who starts all the trouble.
There we go. That's my buddy.
All right, Sam, do you realize that you're part of this, the problem in Eastside Dave's life by coming up with the name Chef Side?
No, I didn't realize.
Yeah, and you're part of the mandate. You are now part of the mandate for the things he's got to change if he wants to keep it.
What can I do?
You know what, Sam? We're still friends.
Okay,
and
good.
And she's losing our friendship, is the way I see it.
Yeah.
And but your name Chef Side did put strain into the relationship.
Although
months ago.
I think it's a nice wordplay. I found it to be very witty. Now you got a beautiful old girlfriend.
Thank you.
I would call her Drunkard's Dream. She seems to take care of you. She doesn't care what you're up to. Does she ever say, "This is what I don't want you to say on the air, and what I do want you to say on the air"?
No, never.
I can't imagine.
No.
I can't imagine that.
No, it doesn't happen.
It couldn't happen. That's the problem here.
You have a nice person in your life. You have a Little Miss Sunshine. I've got Little Miss Dark Days. I've got Little Miss Rain Cloud.
This would be like Anita Pallenberg saying to Keith Richards, "Here's the chords you can't play anymore. These chords I don't want you to play."
I gotta be me.
Yeah.
You know? And it's time just to... She doesn't like me. She doesn't like
who I am.
None
of us do.
Right. Well,
but none of us go around sticking our fingers up a chef's ass. That was another thing he found out. Not only did she blow him, but why she did it. She said what finger was up his ass?
No, but I... And
maybe it was just a pinky. Dainty pinky up
she
there.
She loves to point. It would only make sense that it would be the index.
She put a finger up his ass and I can't call her chef's side?
It does seem like he should be able to get away with chef's side.
I mean,
she's walking around with a dookie finger all day.
Now I agree. I agree with Sammy here.
What about Dookie Digit? Is that a better name for her?
Dookie Digit?
Yeah. See if she's happy with the double D.
I'll ask her if she wants to be the double D Express. And maybe she'll go for it.
Just know it's for Daredevil.
Look, we're not going to be talking too much in a matter of days.
So
here's the real big problem.
Yeah.
My mom is close with her and trying to
it is a problem.
Teacher's jobs. She wants to be a teacher. So how the fuck is this going to work?
But where, in Jersey?
Yeah,
live in New York.
Maybe Jersey.
She's got to commit herself to New York with you if she's going to live with you part-time.
I know. I don't understand. She wants to get a job in North Jersey. So she probably wants to get out anyway. We're all looking for an escape plan here. Thanks to Sam and Chef Side, it can happen.
All right, hold on. Nick came up with a decent thing. Nick, you're on Fez.
Hey, how's it going there, guys? So she's comfortable enough with this guy to blow him and have her finger in his ass, but she didn't fuck him. You think she didn't fuck him?
See, a lot of women will use that criteria of, did you have sex with him? No. All I did was ate his cum. That's all I did. I don't want you to take it the wrong way. And for some reason, for women, that's not intimate to them.
Yeah. Well, I don't think she fucked him. I just don't believe it.
Who cares? She's sitting there with a brown finger, fucking cum dripping out of her lips.
Oh, no.
What's wrong?
Just the visual,
what's bothering
Mr.
you?
B, the visuals that you portray. I'm a very
what
visual
about
person.
She, was done? She puts that finger in her mouth going, your ass tastes so good, Chef.
Oh, Mr. B.
I know what's on the menu. It's fresh cum and brown finger.
And you think you called him Chefy?
Why would she?
That's again, too personal.
Yeah, it is.
Chefy.
You think he called her Chef Side?
He probably did.
After he found out you were East Side, he probably started calling her Chef Side just to get it too.
And by the way, I met this gentleman recently.
No way.
Yes way. Oh, I hate her. I hate her.
Where did you meet him?
We're at... Oh, I forgot this fucking memory. And I honestly blacked this out for like 4 or 5 months. We at the fucking racetrack, because everyone knows, along with my drinking problems, I like to gamble as well.
Sure.
And I bring her to the racetrack, and she's acting all funny and putting her head down and starts, hey, let's go over here, let's go. No, I want to watch this by the front row of the horse track.
What track
were
you at?
Mammoth Racetrack in Jersey. Nice. I like to get right on the fucking line. I like to see my
You got
to
be on the rail.
I got to be there.
You're a rail bird. Why shouldn't you be up front? Why shouldn't you see your fucking money going out of your pocket?
She's shuffling around and things are all weird until I see this big dare I say he looks like, and I'm not saying this just because I saw it yesterday, but the guy from Sawyer from Lost. He was Sawyer from Lost.
Good looking guy then, huh?
Yeah, okay, yeah, 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 he was. So he comes over and he goes, "Hey Claire, it's nice to see you again." And I said,
"Hey Claire, remember that time you had my dick in your mouth and your finger up my ass?
It was
fantastic.
I love this guy.
He was a fucking half a fag. Don't like this guy.
Maybe that was the finger up the ass and only blowjob. Why he's sitting there thinking probably about Bobby Flay. He has to think of Bobby Flay before he could come.
So he goes up to her, and I just see all the color go away from her face, and
she's almost cum-colored at that time.
Exactly. Hmm. Just like, and she goes, "Hi, Kurt. I haven't seen you in such a long time."
"Hi, Kurt."
"Oh, hi, Claire. Let's all talk funny."
"Sure, Kurt. Why not? What are you, fucking meeting puppets?" "No humans talk like that."
All right, she says, "Hi, Kurt. How are you?"
"Oh, hi, Kurt."
"Hi, Claire."
And I'm saying, this is the guy. And he goes, "Yeah, I'm working at a new restaurant now, a new restaurant in Red Bank, New Jersey, where, I'm now the top chef, or I'm the executive chef there." Boom, bada boom. That's all I need to know. By the way, they were looking at each other. Here's the chef. His name is Kurt Sawyer from Lost. Everything's falling together. And I know this is the fucking guy. And so now I have a visual.
Do you remember the name of the restaurant? Try to think. Write it down, because a lot of these places put the pictures of their executive chefs up now. I would love to see it.
I think this is it. I doubt this is it. You want me to say it on the air?
No.
Okay.
Because it's none of our business if he did this. He did what any of us would do.
Yeah.
He mouth-fucked this little thing until he was done.
And by the way, being an executive fucking chef
at this fucking joint,
at that
the
place,
one name, the one nationality that's not known for their food.
Being executive chef at that place is nothing. Okay, so you're an executive chef who knows how to make fucking cheesesteaks and fries. You know who are the money makers there? The fucking bartenders.
No kidding, it's a Mick bar.
Right.
But you did get a blowjob out of it.
Yeah, oh, you true. Son of bitch. You son of bitch and big time double cross.
Wait a minute. When did you turn fucking Albanian on us? "Hey, you son of bitch. I shit fuck you for what you say."
I am so mad I'm forgetting prepositions. That's what I'm trying to say.
"You son of bitch. Out of here. Away from Irish bar."
So I finally met this guy, and I'm serious. I'm having nightmares of him like a fucking dolphin has nightmares of tuna. I mean, it's...
Why would a dolphin, they eat tuna?
Mm-mm. Oh, maybe they do, but they get caught in the nets.
Oh, so the way the dolphins have nightmares of nets.
Tuna nets. So that is just the thing that's been going through my
brain. Was he walking funny, like he had a middle finger up his ass just a little while before?
He was rather uptight walking, yeah. Yes, he was.
"Hi, Claire. Remember that night I treated you like a fuck puppet? Fantastic."
See, I don't need to hear that.
"I came so hard I almost shit all over your finger."
Oh, my God. Now I definitely didn't need to hear that.
"Hey, who's the redheaded idiot? Why don't you tell me you have to take a hot piss and I'll drop another load down your gullet?"
I'll fucking drop you, Kurt. I'll drop you with my fucking fist, baby.
So you didn't spring it up at all?
No, I just sat there horrified, like, how the fuck am I going to... I got so drunk at that horse track, I was betting I bet 2 months of rent. I had to ask my parents for rent money that month.
All right, but when you have gotten that drunk and that stupid anyway, aren't you just fucking blaming?
No, I mean, maybe I'll let one monthly rent go, but I'm not going to blow two of them at the track. I'm kind of responsible, Sam.
I've heard.
So that was
one
of the
most hard. Wow, this place has a 24-ounce steak.
Yeah. It's got a 24-ounce steak. It's, you know what? The food there is highly overrated.
Apparently, it's rated pretty high, though. It may be overrated, but I'm looking this over.
It's overrated, yeah. It's not that great of a place. This guy...
Why would they... it's a nickname, and then they use the name Style Grill. So you're not going to...
Right.
It doesn't even make sense, the fucking name.
Yeah, and the guy who owns it is, like, half Mexican. So it has no personality, it has no identity.
I'm on a Mexican radio. You're in a bad thing there.
My life is falling apart.
Isn't it fucked up with the guy that she banged is better looking than you? That's always the one that hurts.
You know, he yes, it does. All right, fine. I'll just be honest here. But I've got more charisma, and that's all that matters in life.
I might go over there for a meal over to Red.
I hope you don't. I wouldn't.
Well,
I would.
Done his photographs. Wow, nice little place. Oh, it's adorable.
It's a nice place. It's right on the, you know, you can sit outside on Red Bank, New Jersey. Great town. You can look at Kevin Smith's comic book shop right across the street.
Is it really?
Yep. Jay and Silent Bob's Secret Stash right across the street from this place. Great store.
Maybe I'll take Fez down there, get him some comic books, then we'll go meet the chef.
Please don't. Yeah, I really would hope you guys will never encounter Kurt. Kurt! Nice name!
Hi, everybody. Oh, Claire. What a fantastic night.
Hi, Claire. It's Kurt. Nice to see you again.
Sorry it took me so long to come, and you had to chew my cock for 55 minutes. Luckily, the thumb up my ass really got me going.
What a fucking shitbag. If I ever see Kurt again, he's dead. He's a dead man. That's right. Now, the final one. The final mandate. On the West Side Mandate, number 10, don't talk of me and the chef tonguing each other. And God knows what that can mean.
Tongue and ass.
Because now, yeah, now if there's a finger in the ass, yeah. Maybe there's tongue. I originally used to think it was just tonguing, swap and spit, you know, a little French kissing.
He went out on her.
Right.
He
but
a, pussy.
A girl doesn't call, like, giving a blowjob, tonguing another person.
She tongued his ass. She definitely tongued his ass.
I swear to God, if she did... That's it, man. I mean, it is it already, but blammo. Not physically, because I'm a real guy, doesn't hit a woman, but I'll just say it to her face.
Blammo?
Blammo. It's over. And it is. It's
they had a brownie sundae. That sounds fantastic there.
Yeah, well, again, Ron, it's, you know, we don't want to go to Kurt's place.
Why don't we do this? We do like a fucking gig over at his joint and just hang out.
I don't think that's...
Meet the man who fucking rocked East Side Dave's world.
That doesn't seem to be the best idea. We just played the Hard Rock. I think we can find someone in Times Square that will be acceptable.
Here's Seth. Seth, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, I was just wondering, what kind of girl, like, loses her virginity at, what, 20, 25 years old?
How old was she?
And, like, in the beach.
She was about 23 or 22.
Stick with Ron. Get a normal girl.
Yeah, that is kind of odd, don't you think?
What, that it's,
22, 23?
She didn't want it until she met the right guy. And, you know, when you look and you see what I have to offer, I think sometimes...
You end up with a chef.
But she was blowing people.
No, she wasn't blowing people. She said she gave handies out before me.
Not handy, it's up the ass.
Maybe so. See, that maybe she did. And, you know, again, I just don't care for the ass play.
Ward, you're on Ron and Fez.
Look, Dave, I dig you, okay? You're funny, you amuse me, I like you. You can do better than this. I know uglier, fatter, dumb fucking guys who fuck hotter girls than her.
Yeah.
Okay? You can do better than that, all right? You're a producer of a successful radio show.
Two of them.
You should have strippers doing bumps of blow off your cock, for God's sake.
It is very fucking true, because, you know, there's so many fucking girls around radio that'll blow you for a fucking CD. Every fucking intern should know that. So you fucked up. And a lot of it has to do with your attitude. When this Casey showed a fucking little interest in you, you've turned into a fucking jellyfish. You're mumbling and stumbling and talking all kinds of shit. We're just friends. Oh, but if I would, it's crazy talk. It's not what a man does.
No, I mean, yeah, it's not exactly what a man does, but I mean, I'm friends with people. I'm friends with chicks. You know, I can't necessarily hit on all of them. That's not really what a gentleman does either.
No, a gentleman has banged three fucking girls by the time he's 29.
Right.
Stop. First of all, Casey's out of your league.
Okay.
You got to go fucking down lower than that.
All right.
You should really start with some pigs.
Okay.
Start with crack whores and work your way
well,
up.
Well, if they're out there, give me a ring.
Oz, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, fellas.
I got a question for you, Ron. And I was just thinking more about this cheating thing. When we have a girl and she cheats, it goes back to junior high. We always want to blame the guy.
Right.
And we want to beat him up. We want to go have a fight. We want to get irritated. Why don't we blame the girl? Because the guy, as you said, Ron, we're going to fuck whenever we have the chance.
Yeah. No one should really blame this successful chef for getting his fucking knob taken care of. That's not his fault.
No, but they need to blame her for sticking fingers up assholes. I mean, what kind of person does this? You know, whatever I is into sexually, I don't fucking judge.
On a one-night stand?
Whatever. That's between them. Who are we, pilgrims? I don't fucking care. Whatever turns two people on, it doesn't matter to me. The detail work that you two got into is what's got you all freaked out. And the mandate.
Yeah, the mandate's fucking my brain. But she also said, oh, he meant nothing to me. He meant nothing. What kind of person then, like I said, does the fingering of an ass when the person means nothing? I mean, to me, you have to be with someone for 2 years before you finger their ass.
Todd, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, this is Fezzy.
Oh, how are you?
They should have written Fez.
Yeah.
I can't believe that I'm in my deathbed and I'm listening to the fact that I'm listed as three or four of Stink Fingers' mandates of why this relationship broke up.
Yeah.
Fez, you can stop faking. It's just us. We don't care whether you're taking a week off.
I'm not faking. I'm definitely ill.
Mm-hmm. If you were, wouldn't Wiki have checked on you by now?
I would have thought so. I don't understand why Claire hates me. I don't understand why Wiki hates me.
Has Wiki tried to get a hold of him, Earl?
As far as I know, no, not at all.
Why not? Why is he mad? He sent us that email about ball players. We said we'd take them all, right?
Yeah, we said yes to that, but he hasn't said anything about, you know, how Fez's doing. He hasn't said anything about that.
Odd.
That's very odd, because Wiki and I were close for a while. We would talk three or four times a week when I was well. Now I get sick and there's nothing.
Wow, that is odd.
It's very, very strange.
All right, you're out, I guess. The only thing I can come up with.
So I don't know where this comes from with Wiki.
All right, Fezzy, you taking care of yourself, buddy?
I'm doing my best, yeah.
All right, pal.
All right.
Here is Biggs. Biggs, you're on the air.
Hey, listen, Eastside Dave, I am one of your biggest fucking supporters, bro.
Thank you.
I really am. But when you're at a racetrack having a good time with your girl and you meet the guy that fucks her in her mouth and takes a ass and you don't have the gut to say something, bro, what the fuck is wrong with you?
What should he say? It's none of his business.
Plus, we were on a break.
What do you mean it's... Oh, you're on a break.
We were.
Still, dude, a finger in the ass. I'd rather have a guy fucking fuck my girl in her fucking quad than fucking have the fucking guy soul fucker, bro.
Yeah, but you know what? I Biggs, I'm going to let you go here so we can talk this over. I completely disagree. Whatever she does, you're not with her anymore.
Right.
This guy didn't know you.
He didn't.
He's not, and really, everybody's going to do what they want to do. He didn't rape her.
No.
There's no reason for you to be angry with the executive chef.
Yeah, I mean, I try to be civilized. I think I try to come across, you know, I'm trying to be a more debonair person.
You drank, you cried, you wasted all your money at the track.
All right, those three things don't exactly point to being civilized, but at least I was trying. And the point was, the guy had nothing, no idea of me, because we weren't going out.
Right.
So, well, you know.
That's not his fault, but why are you still angry with him this moment? Who's this chick on CNN? Looks unbelievable.
That's Sarah Sheffield.
Gary Sheffield?
Sarah Sheffield. She's a reporter for CNN. She covers stories on location.
She's doing a great job. Look at her. Gary Sheffield has fucking turned so hot.
Sarah Sheffield.
Did Sheffield step down or is he still playing?
He's on the White Sox. He's on the Tigers.
Isn't it time for him to retire?
Tigers.
Put an end to it.
If he's healthy, he's still productive.
Still. I hate to see him limp out like this. All right, there's Gary Sheffield right now working CNN in a phenomenal way. Phenomenal way.
That's Sarah Sheffield.
Paul, you're on Fez.
Hey, Dave. Do you think maybe Westside's wanting to move to Jersey to be closer to her chef that's working in Jersey?
It's quite possible, homie. Because
that's the reason she's trying to get a job there.
You might be onto something, Paulie, because
You guys fought last night, right?
Yes.
She was listening to the show yesterday.
Yeah.
What was the specific problem she had yesterday?
Yesterday, talking about her in derogatory terms and then bringing up that I like other chicks. That I'm talking to other chicks. I mean, not doing anything even.
But let's face it. We're finding out other chicks are interested in you.
Yes. I found that out. And she's all upset and all mad. Well, you know what? That ship has sailed. The SS Davy sails on.
What's that
to, mean? To greener waters.
Watership blue.
Something.
There's something wrong with these waters. They've turned green.
You mean greener pastures, Dave.
Exactly.
How are you going to sail through a pasture, Earl?
Yeah.
No, he's just got all his references crossed up and mixed up.
But you're saying you want him to sail to greener pastures. He's going to run his fucking boat ashore. That's no good. You're going to break a propeller.
Only Earl would suggest I get shipwrecked. And it's just not funny, man.
I think a fucking
moment like this?
Yeah. I think you've been shipwrecked.
I have.
In this fucking relationship.
And there's no one in the lighthouse, Mr. B.
What are you doing on a sandbar? When you should be out there in the deep waters.
Right.
Trolling.
That's right. I have my kayak all ready to go. And I'm going to be trolling in the deep waters now.
Now you're on a kayak instead of a ship?
Well, I'm gonna...
What are you, like a fucking Alaskan? What are you, the Nook in the North? So you're going after walrus. Smart move.
Yeah.
Good way to fucking get used to this.
Yeah, you gotta get back in.
Big girls with mustaches and lacking teeth. Mm-hmm. All right.
But hearty laughs. Hearty laughs.
Sure, hearty laughs.
Just like a walrus.
You want a girl to fake a laugh for you?
Oh, yeah, I like that. No, I don't want any fake laughs. No.
Don, you're on the Fez.
Hey, buddies.
Yeah.
Hey, Dave, it sounds like you're just a little envious there. I don't think you ever got a finger up your ass or the old tongue.
He had a paw up his ass, and I ain't going to say how, but a dog got a paw up his ass.
I've had things up my ass. I don't find them to be sexual.
Which have up your ass?
Well, there was a couple of bagels on the Opie and Anthony program, and again...
That's when you shut down the O&A producers. Are you guys still stinging from that loss, Sam?
We haven't had anything since then. What can we do to him? He's got bagels up his ass.
By the way, look at Than just dying to get in here. Just come in. You don't have to be Fezzy and go, oh, wait, he's on the air and I'm not. Let me stand outside. Come in. Always feel comfortable. It's so funny about a team. If one guy hears the other on the air, he goes, well, why aren't I on the air? This is ruining our team. Go ahead, Than.
These cans are on. My apologies. I was texting Sam about, don't you have some work to do? And
oh, so he's letting you down.
Yeah.
What's he supposed to be doing now?
No, just, I was making fun of the fact that he was coming in without
me. He's rocking the fucking mic.
Oh, I hear
him. Is what he's doing, Than.
Yeah.
He's rocking the mic. Than, you're a man of the world.
Yes.
What should Dave do about this? Should he stay and try to make it work? I think he should. I'm going to vote stay.
What?
I don't think you're going to get another woman.
What are you talking about?
I know you. You're not going to get another woman.
You gave me an hour's advice of why I should leave.
I think you're in a fucked up relationship, but I still think that she's all you're going to get.
I just don't think so. I've lost 7 pounds. I'm ready to move on.
Really?
Yes.
What do you think, Than?
I say bail.
Get out now, huh?
Yeah. I've seen a lot of negative indicators.
Yeah.
She knows Than quite well. We've gone out and drink together.
Yeah. And, I'm just not seeing a good fit there, Dave.
Than, how's your relationship going with our other intern?
You know.
You want to keep that one private?
It's ups and downs.
Ups and downs?
More downs, maybe?
What, is it not working out?
No.
What happened, Bobby Pantera? Wow.
Yes, I was a little... He bullied me.
Did he really?
No. Damn it. All right. Well, yeah. It just... I don't want to maybe get into every detail.
Uh-huh. You make me feel like the O&A guys are kind of girlish. You know what I mean? Have you noticed that? As masculine as Opius, masculine as Anthony is, the staff comes off a little girlish. Sam? Yeah. Well, you know, Than is like your leader, your unofficial leader.
Delicate.
Yeah, they're delicate boys.
Prissy.
Yeah.
Whoa, easy. We have audio of you screaming like a girl many times.
That's pussy. That's totally different.
Okay.
All right, so what's happening? What's going on there?
You're our leader. Man up.
You know, just there wasn't necessarily a... Oh, man, I just feel brutal dissecting something on
air. It's got to be done, though.
Yeah.
So it didn't work out for you?
No.
I'm stunned by that. She's a very pretty girl. She seemed like she liked you a lot.
Mm-hmm.
But it was the fact that she'd been around the show too much, dating too many guys.
That didn't help.
Sam, so. What was it really? He's too much of a gentleman.
I think maybe there wasn't as deep of a connection as he was looking for.
Really? You're looking for love then, huh?
Of course he is. Look at him.
Yeah, he is. He's adorable. Oh, and he seems like, and after I found out you play classical piano, you're the type any father would love.
Yeah.
Oh, where is that classical piano player who's got so many nice... Dave, totally the opposite.
Yeah, I'm just a fucking meathead drummer.
And
I got
you're not a fucking drummer. You lie. You never drum anywhere.
Because I can't. I could. There's no drums here at the station. Otherwise,
bro, everybody fucking drummed the other night but you.
Well, I was preparing for a wrestling match. I mean, that's one thing that I had
Michael was out there drumming. Mikey D's drumming. Those guys are great drummers. You are not. You're not a fucking good drummer.
I am a good drummer.
You don't even own the drums.
I do own drums in my house in Jersey. I can't move them into Queens, Mr. B.
Fez, Earl, do we got to put up with this fucking crazy talk
I'm
with him?
I'm a drummer, dude.
You're not.
He says he's a drummer, but I've heard him, like, just tap on a table. He can never keep time.
Are you fucking kidding me?
You can't keep time.
You play any song, and I will keep time. Badass.
Wipe out.
I gotta hear it.
Oh, God, that's it. All right, play me a fucking song.
Yeah.
Play me a song, and let's see if the guy can fucking play. Why your hands hurt? Well, no, drum. You've got girl hands
You're
for a drummer.
You're supposed to use drumsticks.
Yeah.
Let's get some pens.
Let me see your hand. Here. Pull it over. This is a fucking drummer's hand? What is it? That's not a fucking
come on.
Drummer's
come
hand.
On. Come on, come
That's
on.
Not a drummer's hand. What's wrong?
You squeezed it
you
real hard.
I couldn't hurt fucking... Look at his face. You're ready to pass out. I could not do that to Mikey D's fucking hand.
I wasn't prepared for it. If I was prepared...
All right, let me just see your fingers. Bring your fucking fingers over. Just put them like this. Let me see if this is a... if it's a drummer's finger. Is that a drummer's finger?
No, get off me! No, please, drummer!
This is impossible to believe.
What the fuck? What kind of, like, medieval handlock was that?
That's what anyone could... Here, do it to me. All you do, put your fingers between mine and then you squeeze.
All right.
All right, just go and squeeze now. You squeeze here. No. Like this.
But,
why would you do it again? Why would you do the same thing that hurts so bad?
I was going to get you. I thought you were setting me up. Oh.
Yeah.
How did you learn that? That's like some fucking...
It's not men do. It's not men do. Don't make a big deal out of it.
Yeah.
All right, we're about to... I didn't even notice that she was here today. It's, I guess, Stan, it's your ex?
Yeah.
Wow, is this uncomfortable?
No, it's fine.
Wow. So, dumped again?
No.
What are you, 0-for-4 since I've known you now? You're taking a collar. I don't want you to take this the wrong way. I'm going to sit you a couple days. I'm going to bring another girl in and let her see if she can get the bat off her shoulder. It's not so much that you're swinging and missing. I don't see you swinging.
I'm fine.
You're repelling men one after another. I can't have this. It's too much. It's a bad reflect. You can't look at Than, right?
No, I can.
You can't look at Bobby. You can't look at Than. Who were the other ones that she was with around here?
Pitsy.
And Pitsy.
Earl.
No, she's in love with
Pitsy. Oh, Earl.
I'm in love with
Pitsy. Oh, you dumped Earl.
No, I didn't dump Earl.
Here's the thing. Only one guy really loves you and wants to stick with you. You won't give him the time of day because of skin color. And thickness, you said. His skin is too thick and black.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, hold on here. You are going to judge. Play us a song, Earl, so we can hear this fucking drummer. Oh, stop it, Earl. Fucking put that away. That's ridiculous. Give me a fucking rock song, and we'll see if he can keep time. Or, Jimmy, give me some Jim Krupa. Let's see if he's really fucking ready to do this
thing. Jim Krupa? He's one of the best ever.
Are you happy with this thing? You felt like it wasn't working out, or did you have your feelings hurt low?
No, I'm fine.
Yeah.
I'm fine.
But was it a shock to you?
Not really, no.
You know it wasn't working out?
Right.
Okay.
Mmm.
Mm. What?
A little bit of a...
denial problem.
You know this was all happening?
I have a denial problem.
I learned about it a couple days ago.
I got to get part of the gossip
poll. I was really
sad. I'm not part of the gossip poll run. Were you sad?
Yeah, because I thought Fan and Will was...
You're still rubbing away
I'm a little
there.
Nervous.
Yeah.
that you're going to break my hand again. I thought Fan and Lil were going to make it because they're both tall.
Yeah. So what is that?
Wow.
I don't know.
Giraffes? You a zookeeper now?
Yeah, but medieval they just seem so perfect, perfectly tall. Together.
What was it about you that her personality is just not enough there? It's all surface with her? It's a pretty face and nothing else?
No, she's very nice.
Yeah. Well, that part's a lie. But
I am a very nice person.
I saw. You know what? You're really not. But that has nothing to do. That has nothing to do with anything. Only because of the way you treated Earl. But there's no depth to her. That's the big problem. There's nothing underneath of it.
I would not say that either.
Well, something was a turnoff.
Just that click that
didn't happen.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
That's all right.
I mean, it seems like you don't click with anyone. That's right. Why I feel bad.
It's all right.
Maybe you can get back with Jivin.
No. Definitely not.
Just the spark doesn't go.
Bobby P?
No. Oh.
I'd like to see you with Mafia Life Chris. Mafia Life Chris would be perfect. Oh, he's with Frenchie.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, let's see her, Earl. Here you go, big man. The place. He's all over the fucking place. Why do you got your tongue out?
Concentrate. This is fucking jazz.
That's terrible.
Can you fucking play some rock?
How
God
bad?
Damn.
You're a man who knows music. How bad was that?
Yeah, I was a drummer for about 6 years.
How bad was that?
Not sweet.
Yeah.
That it's jazz. I play rock. I play Mr. Brownstone. I play Stairway to Heaven. I play rock. I don't play your fucking black girl Miles Davis shit.
All right, hold on. Here's Jim. Jim, you're on Run Fez.
Hey, Lil, I got the perfect guy for you.
Who's that?
Hey.
A big A! What's your thought there?
Yeah, no.
Are you dating anyone now?
No.
All right, we got to find you somebody.
No, it's quite right. I'll find somebody for myself.
Yeah.
I know who would be who she was looking at for maybe Friday night at least. Moochie.
Ah, you want to go with Moochie? Moochie's my friend from Belfast.
You know who he is.
Now, the good thing here is he's leaving on Friday. We're having a going away party for him on Friday. Would you like to go?
Maybe.
What are you saying, maybe? Why do you got to be like that? You either in or out. The beauty of this is he leaves just about when it's time to get to know you. So he doesn't find out that you're all surface.
Right. It's a good idea. But I thought that's Winnie Cooper's boy.
No. They're just friends.
Oh, right.
They're just buddies.
They're just internet pals.
Unlike you, she's able to have friends with males. That's the beauty of it.
That's right.
Or you think what I'm thinking. Minaj with Winnie.
No. No.
They have some problems.
No, we don't.
You guys having problems?
No. She's actually very, very nice.
It's just the vibe that I picked up on.
You want me to bring a big bag of Coke and a bunch of C-notes where I keep throwing them at you? You know, making you do more? Here's Cracker. You're on Ron Fez.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Yeah.
I'm just curious how rock stars like Dan, Sam, Esav, how the hell you got banging fans left and right, interns, and not even looking back, not even caring.
Why do I get confused with this?
Now, Fan handled himself like a gentleman, right?
Oh, yeah.
He got out early before treating you like...
shit?
I wasn't going to say shit. I was just going to say like a jizz towel. But he is not like that, correct?
No, actually, he's actually very nice. Really couldn't say a bad thing about him.
You might be gay then when you break up with a woman
and
she can't say a bad thing about you. You attracted to guys?
Not very much at all.
I have the perfect guy for you, but he has bronchitis. here's Brian. Brian, you're on Run Fez.
Hey, I was thinking maybe you could play something by Def Leppard. Dave's got 50% more arms than that guy, and maybe he's got a better shot of keeping up.
I will blow that fucker away.
And no footwork with your nose, right? The feet were just... You were sitting on your feet.
There's no drum pedals here.
Yeah, I'm just saying, though.
I can do it. If I have sticks and if I have a rock song to play with...
You don't own drums.
I own.
You've never been in a band.
I have been in a band.
What band?
Guys with Ears. It was very popular in on the Jersey Shore. From my age of 15 to 19, Guys with Ears ruled Belmar and Spring Lake, New Jersey, like no other band has before or since. And let me tell you something. If I could hear a rock song, I could really play you some stuff.
You pick this song.
I want to hear Mr. Brownstone. Because that has great drums. I'm not going to hear some Chet Parker song.
Go ahead, Earl. Mr. Brownstone. Mark, you're on Fez.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Yeah.
Hey, this girl Lil, the way she comes across on the radio, she sounds really hot, but at the same time, you can hear that flat, cold bitchiness that just comes through the radio.
You know what? Here's the thing. No. Right. I don't think that your full personality has reached the air yet. You are a little, you hold on a little bit, you're a little too tight, you need to let go. But I don't think you're a real personality. Because I think she's a fun girl, don't
yes,
you think?
Yes, definitely.
A lot of fun. Than you would even say that, right? You went on a date with her.
Yeah.
The only problem is, for Than probably is you date around a lot in the same circles. You probably got to spread it out a little bit. Sam, you agree with that?
Could be it.
Yeah.
I mean,
I'm sure he came to you crying like this isn't working out, right?
He did. I'd advise him the whole way through, every step.
What was it that pushed it up? Bobby Pantera's big cry fest?
It didn't help.
Yeah. Bobby, by the way, sent me a huge, long email saying that I took your side and that was the straw that broke the camel. And his feelings were really, really hurt because he thought I stuck up for you and Lily, too.
Well, I did nothing wrong, so.
Yeah, but I think he just wanted me to be on his side.
Right.
And I was, and I... you probably don't know this from me, neither. I know you guys. I tend to stir things up a little bit. So he took that the wrong way. And now... Dave, I don't know whether you know about this because you were too busy getting beat up. But just John came to me after the show with some free FM. I guess they were giving out shirts or selling shirts.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Free FM was.
So he comes up to me and goes, where did they get this logo? And I go, I have no idea. I've never seen the shirt before. Not, you know, it came from our site and we didn't get any mentions.
Oh, God.
I go, you know, all right, I'll bring it up to Earl. But, you know, you have a lot of audio on that site. That Free FM and XM.
And also the name Ron and Fez. I mean, they're taking your name and
well,
your
Well, with us, but we say, yeah, you're allowed to do that. We don't want to have a problem. But I guess Free FM should check with you, Earl, before they go and make up shirts. Did they talk to anybody?
This is the first time hearing about all of
you. You didn't see the shirts?
I mean, I saw the shirts, but I didn't know there was a I thought that they were... They had made the logo on their own, but I didn't know.
You saw that was a logo that the front page of RonFez.net was using.
Yeah, I understand that, but there were so many different, you know, designs floating out there. I didn't know it came directly.
There was only one design was on the front page of the website and then was on the T-shirt.
No, but I mean...
Why are you so upset, Lily?
No, I'm not.
Why you got your back turned to the boys?
I don't.
You're nervous.
No, not really.
You need to let your full personality come out on the air.
There's just some really weird eye contact back and forth there.
Then, am I going crazy here? Let me just say it. Could you try it one more time?
Yeah.
One more time, take her out and see if you can make this thing work. Lily, I know you'd be all for it. Because there's something special happening between you kids, and I don't want any of these side things to get in the way. One moment, please. Here's Frenchie.
Okay.
Frenchie.
Hi, guys. How are you?
How are you?
I'm doing good. I miss Fezzy, but
who?
I love Soundboard Fezzy also. Free FM refused to hand out the shirts at the end of the night, and they were giving people a hard time. And they also came up to the the rally towels that we were handing out, and told us to stop, and they had a check with Tom Chiasano. And Al Dukes came over to us and said, you're fine, keep going, hand them out, everything's fine.
Who is this from Free FM that always has these rules, Earl? It's too many rules.
I mean, I was told from the beginning, like, with the rally towels, that was cool. That was cool with Hard Rock John. He cleared that from the beginning. So I don't know where this came from.
Yeah, I told her, I said, well, Hard Rock Johnny gave us permission to be here, and Ron and Fez gave us permission. And she said, well, I'll have to check with my boss, Tom Chiasano.
Who is this? Is this the promotions head?
Yeah, that's Jody.
And she was all your problems, right?
Yeah, we
so last night Tom came to me and he goes, "We love the show. We love everything you guys do. But next time, let's let promotions handle all the tickets." And I go, "We got to make sure that the hardcore people get their tickets. I can't fucking bounce somebody that's listened to the show for years because somebody who just started 2 weeks ago started listening. Fair is fair." So I don't know what the fuck goes on. But
that was the best part of the night, that all the fans were there, the hardcore fans.
Now, you wrote me some other email that I didn't really understand about the Pal Talks thing. Do I need to plug something differently, Frenchie?
No, there's just two Ron and Fez Pal Talk rooms that are in the on Pal Talk now.
See, I don't know how that works. I don't go to the Pal Talk.
Yeah, I know. I didn't think that everybody knew that there was two rooms that stream the shows live.
All right, Earl, Fez, Dave, then you should plug those, whoever you are.
Yeah, I like the Ron and Fez room that's done by Dugout Doug. And
Well,
Happy
he doesn't
girl.
Do that room, so.
Happy Typing Girl does.
Well, what's the
no,
other
she
room?
Doesn't either.
We can plug both rooms.
All right, big-ass yeah. room, big-ass Ron Fez room is Frenchie's room, and Frenchie Mafia Life Chris's.
Schnipdick actually owns the other room and runs that room. And
do the two rooms not get along with each other?
There's just been some problems, certain things. Certain people don't like things we do in our room.
Well, I heard that Frenchie doesn't like to share.
That
I heard that she's power hungry.
I saw her sharing with women before, so I know she's nice.
It was just some people's personal problems with certain people. They had problems with my boyfriend, Mafia Life Chris. They had problems with Spread the Iris. And specific people went to the other room, which is fine. They streamed the show live and let people hear it that can't hear it. So it's just some people go in one room and some people go in the other room. We have replays going and best of all right.
Well, Dave, you be in charge of plugging both rooms.
All right.
Everybody should get a plug.
All righty.
All right, Frenchie.
Bye, guys. Thanks.
All right, bye-bye. All right, Lily, I tried to get him back into it, but it doesn't look like it's going that way.
And it's fine.
So, we got the little Mick for you. Is that an opportunity?
Who?
What's his name? Mooch.
Moochie.
He's a little Mick. He's from Ireland. The only problem is, Dave said he was grabbing your dick quite a lot the other day.
He grabbed my cock on multiple occasions and tried to give me a wedgie. But he does have that accent that you like so much.
Right.
Yeah, but I don't know. No. I'm just not going to date.
You're done dating like a nun? Get thee to a nunnery?
Yes.
Wow, then.
I made her lesbo.
I didn't say lesbian. I'm not going to date.
Are you thinking about dating women, though?
No.
I think you'd do great with a woman.
I probably would, but
yeah,
I'm not attracted to women.
Did you maybe ever try to double date with Sam and his chick? Maybe when you guys went out. That way all the pressure wouldn't be on you two.
She was complimenting my chick an awful lot earlier today.
Yeah, of course she was. She is. She's definitely thinking that. Plus, your chick has the look the chicks dig. Because a couple women have already brought that up to me.
Wow.
And I don't want you to take this the wrong way.
No.
If Dan was a man, I'd do a fucking three-way with them. And I go, he is a man. Because a lot of people think you're underage.
Who, me?
Yeah.
That's weird.
Yeah, I know. I said that. I'll just, leave it at that. But here's Joe. Joe, you're on Run a Fez.
Yeah, I just want to call Gabe out. I've never heard of his band. I grew up on the Jersey Shore.
Where?
I grew up in Keyport, New Jersey.
Keyport.
Which is not...
Keyport,
not too far from Belmar in that.
Keyport, though, ain't the mean streets of Belmar and Spring Lake. That's where you have to go for the music.
I've been hanging around bands and all that, and I've never seen you at Fast Lanes when they had the award show for local bands.
We never played Fast Lanes.
Why not? If that's where the big awards show is.
We played the Coffee House in Belmar.
Do you have any of your own original music?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We had a title called Bunsen, not named after the burner, but the character on the Muppets. I played drums and sung.
Burner.
Yeah.
Sorry.
I played drums and sung lead vocals.
Like Lee Von Helm?
Exactly. Just like Lee Von. Or the guy from the Romantics.
Why didn't you just sing Desperado and you could have been like the Eagles?
I don't like the Eagles, but I do love Lee Von. He's my hero.
Isn't he doing a show in New York pretty soon?
St. Patrick's Day at the Beacon.
Let's all go.
I wanted to. I asked Earl for tickets. He couldn't come through, so I'm now going to Shane McGowan.
You can't get tickets for Lee Von Helm?
No, I didn't say I could not get you tickets. I said that's going to be... I know his manager, so it's not going to be a problem. I just need to know how many tickets he needs, and how, and it'll probably be a few days before the event before I find out anything.
Steve, you're on Fez.
Yeah, hey Ron, what's up? I did the logo for the Eastside Dave Midnight Rider.
Oh, nice job, Steve.
Yeah, and you know, I've done quite a few things for you guys, and no one asked me shit about it, you know, about using it, and which is fine. I do it for the show. But, you know, I got pushed around a little by the Free FM people at the show. I came in from Ohio, you know, and it just left a little bit of bad feeling in my mouth. I'm doing something for them, and they, bad taste in my mouth. They're doing something for them, and they, you know, they weren't very friendly.
How'd they push you around?
Well, I mean, I was just taking some pictures. They're like, hey, don't stand here. Hey, don't do this, you know. Yeah. Just different stuff, you know. I don't know who it was, just some of the people.
The Free FM station, there's zero coolness there.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying,
Earl? It was really annoying.
And I know Tom wants them to run everything, but there's no cool factor at all. You can't be pissing people off. You can't fight with the guy who designed the shirt. You can't fight with Frenchie, who's out promoting the show on Pal Talk and on her website. Just doesn't make sense. It's bad business.
Yeah, I mean, I've done quite a few things for you guys, you know. Yeah. And
we love it all.
And I enjoy doing it.
Yeah.
Little respect the show would be great.
Yeah, you're right about that. Earl, you got to start and make sure. I know you've got a lot on your plate, but, you know, anybody who does something should be treated nice.
Yeah, Steve, I'm sorry about that. I'm sorry you had a hassle, and it was a great logo. Unbelievable logo.
Yeah,
so
no
for that,
problem.
He should let someone shit in his mouth, Earl? What's your suggestion now?
No, not at all.
Swallow the shit?
No, not at all. There would be no shit swallowing.
Well, I'll keep sending the stuff in, you know. It's no
right.
big deal to me, so.
All right. Thank you very much, my friend.
All right, man.
All right, bye.
Bye.
Who can you sit down with over there and say that they're treating people like garbage? It's like they're shitting in people's mouths. Because I think that's why Wiki hasn't talked to us anymore. Because he feels like he got his mouth shit in.
No, I can talk to the boss.
What boss?
I can talk to Minnelli about it.
Minnelli didn't know what was going on that night. You know what he said to me? Not since Jack Benny did a show during World War II. You know, he doesn't care about that. You've got to make sure that they have nothing to do with the next show.
Yeah,
and that's what Chiasano is pushing for. He's in Jody's corner.
Yeah, we can make that happen.
You can't make it happen. You would have made it happen this time.
Nah.
So don't go and guaranteeing things. And last time it got taken away from you, right?
Yes.
So, right. So you can't make it happen next time, right?
Well, I have a little bit more clout this time than I did going into...
So what are you going to tell them?
It's like, don't shit in people's mouths. Don't.
That's crazy. Seriously, that's insane. They're going to yell, whose mouth did I shit in? What you need to do is talk like a real person, like a business person.
Yeah, I can. It was just bad business to treat. No, I mean, if you're treating the guy who designed the logo.
Don't try to guess what I'm saying. Figure out what we're going to do next time. Because you got a big problem. That's they want Jody to run everything. And Tom already came to me about that. And he's like, I love the fact that Earl's running the, you know, he can be the guy going, oh, we're coming back on the air. This is the thing. But we will run all the tickets next time. You know he said that, right?
Yes.
So you don't take that as a bad thing?
That's a very bad thing. I mean, I thought, you know...
You just told me a second ago you would take care of everything, though.
No, but I can, you know, I can sit down and talk with him about that and say, hey, look, we can handle...
All right, let's put... Lil, you're going to be in charge of this because you seem to have Tom wrapped around your finger. He goes to your dad's restaurant.
Yeah.
I think he's a little sweet on you. He wants to play bad baby.
I don't know. I mean, I've known Tom for a while.
He said he wanted to play bad babysitter with you. So that means... And he got braces just because he wanted to, you know, look like you. So... have you noticed that?
Yeah.
He's pulling that thing from that Paul Thomas Anderson film.
It's the weird braces, too. It's the ones that you're trying to pretend that you have teeth.
Yeah.
Like, no one can see them.
Right. He's like the Wiz Kid, Donnie.
Yeah, so it just looks like
from
you have, like, three, like, stale chiclets glued onto your already existing teeth.
All right, so how are you going to handle this?
Next event, I'll single-handedly handle all the tickets.
Using your charm?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Then, can you get back with her before this happens? Why don't you give her one for the road? Why don't you give her one for the road, just so she knows what it's like?
Because
that's one you like to get in your book, right, Than?
I don't.
You
really
keep a book of conquests, right?
No, you know what? Honestly, I can count on less than one hand the amount of men that I've been intimate with in my life.
All right,
so
let's go through.
It's really not that.
Because I know Jibin, Bobby Pantera, and so you've only got two other fingers if it's less than one hand.
Well, those are two of the four.
Really? There's only been four?
Yep.
And I know two of them.
Yes, only two.
So you really started to switch gears when I met you. At that point, you thought, I'm going to get this book done. All right, the other one was a bad uncle, you said, so that's one.
One
and I don't even think that should count.
One, the first one was my first boyfriend.
Uh-huh.
And then there was another guy that I dated after that, and then there was Jiven, and then...
Bobby, and you wanted Thanet to be the thumb. And he refused your thumb. That doesn't seem too many to me, Than. Four.
Oh, I never had a problem with her history.
You don't ever... It's more personality?
It's really not history. It's like...
It's present.
Well, it is a history. Everyone has got a history. Wow. You've got the Fab Four. That's yours.
Yeah.
I wanted Than to be the fifth Beatle. I really did. I wanted him to be George Best. All right, so... No, George Best is the soccer player who played, yes, and they called him the fifth Beatle.
You're right.
Pete Best is the guy they kicked out.
Sorry.
That would have been that other boyfriend in high school who you broke up with and then slept with the very next guy. Remember him? All girls do that. They break up with their long-term boyfriend who tried to force them to have sex, and then they bang the very next guy they date.
No, no. Actually, it takes me a very long time to bounce back. After Jiven, it was 7 months.
7 months, yeah. Before Bobby Pantera?
Mm-hmm.
Bobby Pantera, you broke that quick, right?
Yeah.
That happened fast.
Yeah.
One day. So you're really getting better. Because he thought, now, if you had to look it up, do you wish you would not bump Bobby Pantera for 10?
No.
You're glad you did.
I mean, it was what it was.
He's just a caller character, and you had to bump him for a producer.
He's not a producer.
Not a bad substitution.
Oh, man, see? I feel like I should start screaming to protect Bobby, because if not, he's going to have his feelings hurt. All right, so you have one, well, it's a rocky road for you right now, I guess.
No, it's fine. It's not
so
rocky.
So you really are going to take skip men for a while.
Maybe.
You know, just as you're breaking up with Ann, Dave is breaking up with his longtime girlfriend.
Aww.
That's right.
Now, the interesting thing is here, you've slept with more people than Dave.
That's
Dave,
right.
You three plus a dog.
Exactly. But my three were all Europeans, and I find that exotic sort of thing maybe adds another one.
Well, wait a minute. I mean, what I would say right now is that Lily is an Albanian Muslim.
Hmm. I've never had non-Christians before.
It's not
is it
so
great?
Much different.
Do you not accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
I'm not religious at all.
Mm-hmm.
I don't believe in religion.
Can I talk to you a little bit about our Lord? Can I try
sure,
to?
If you'd like to.
I would. I don't know all the details, but from what I understand, he's very old, but nice.
Mm. Not interested.
Not interested in Jesus.
Mm.
Wow.
Would that be a turnoff for you?
Yeah. I mean, Jesus is my hero. You know, that's the guy I look up to. We
sure.
More than anybody.
Was he an only child?
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
I heard he had brothers and sisters.
Mm-hmm.
Earl, where are you on the brothers and sisters of Jesus?
I thought he had like two brothers.
Yeah. Was he the middle child or was he the oldest?
I thought he was the oldest child because Mary was a virgin.
Oh, that's true. I didn't even think of that. All right, so he had two brothers, no sisters?
As far as I know, no, he didn't have any sisters.
By who? Mary was
Joseph. These were Jesus' half-brothers.
Mary never banged again. She was always a virgin.
She stayed a virgin.
She stayed a virgin.
What did Joseph do?
I guess he probably spanked it. I mean, I don't know what Joseph did, but he did something. But, I mean, Mary,
if I was Mary, I'd let him fool around. I would say to myself, you know what? You're protecting my virginity. I want you to get out and get your freak on every once in a while.
She probably did. The girl was a saint, for crying out loud.
A little.
Literally.
Well, no, she really wasn't a saint.
I think she's been made a saint since.
No, she's up above saint. Here's Jacob. She got her own prayer. Not too many people can say that. Only one other guy got a prayer, and that's God.
It's the best prayer, too.
All
the Catholic
people,
because it's so fast.
Yeah.
I can say it within like 30
By the
seconds.
Way, when I was a kid, go ahead, do a fast one.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now at the hour of death. Amen.
You can always tell the people that had to say rosaries, because we can go very, very quick. That's the way we'd always pray. But the thing there, too, is when I was a kid, always prayed to Mary first. I don't like asking men for things. I'm like, Mary, do me a favor. When you talk to Jesus, work this out. Because women I can ask forgiveness for. Men, I'm like, yeah, please, don't fucking start on me.
Yeah.
You know, then suddenly you're like, you're out in the yard, and it's all going to get ugly.
If you want something really bad enough, do 50 Hail Marys. And I'm talking something realistic. It almost always works for me.
Mm-hmm.
Almost always. And I learned that from the old man in the sea, who caught a giant fish.
And what happened to that fish when he got back to
him? Well, it became a carcass. Yeah,
but you got to read the end of the book before you say this is a great way to go.
But at least he caught the fish.
Yeah. Earl, didn't you read, in your school, you read The Old Carp in the Sea. What happened there?
Not the old carp.
Have you ever used a reel when you fished, or is it always cane pole?
Used a reel? We weren't that backwards.
Go down south, them fuckers are still down there, sitting out in front of a goddamn drainage ditch with a cane pole.
My father, he goes to, Nag's Head every year?
Yeah.
And he said there's always someone with a pole older than dirt. So you could tell, like, he built this thing when he was a kid.
Jacob, you're on first.
Yeah, I wanted to remind you, with Eastside, it's three girls, a dog, and a jar of jelly.
Yeah, you did bang a jelly
and
jar.
Throw in the inflatable doll while we're at it. I mean, what does that prove?
Where'd you fucking inflatable doll? I never even heard that story.
Yeah, I think I've discussed. Maybe I haven't. I was pretty lonely at one point, and I got an inflatable doll, and it was like 3 feet tall.
So inflatable midget doll.
So I remember being so disappointed because on the box it looked like Vivica Fox.
Right.
But I like black. I like all types of chicks. And so I'm banging the thing and I'm so depressed. Not only is it plastic, you know, but it's a midget. And by the way, it had an anal input. So I'm banging it there and it pops midstream or like mid banging.
Yeah, I think most of those things are just for a joke. They're not to actually
no,
do.
There's holes there.
Yeah, I know, but it's like the joke to, you know, put up at the office for everybody to laugh. Not to go home and fuck it. Let's face it, it's a pool float.
Yeah.
It fucking looks and smells like a pool float.
Well,
the only thing I would do is fucking lay down on it to get a tan.
Well, then that's false advertising. Because that's what the fucking...
Sue the adult store. Be the fucking idiot who's going to end up in court going, Your Honor, I got my ass in the anal implant and ended up as nothing.
Fine. Pussy Cat Boutique, you might be getting held into court. But anyway, I'm banging it and it pops and I hear the air going out of it. Very slowly, and the only thought that I had to that went through my brain was I have to finish before all the air is out. So I picked up my pace,
and I'm willing to say that's the only thought that's ever gone through your brain. But go ahead. So you picked up the pace.
I picked up my pace, was going real hard,
yeah.
And I cut my cock on the anal rectum of this plastic blow up doll, and so I'm just banging it like
Earl's leaving. Earl's leaving about your bloody cock,
and I'm like, "Fuck! I gotta finish." It's finally like a buzzer beater shot. I completed the act. I jizzed all over her, and the last wheezing of the plastic went out of her, and I looked down, and it was just a plastic puddle with blood and ejaculate all over it. It was the most disgusting.
He said her like it's a real girl.
Yeah. You know, I mean, I think we've all fucked a dying girl, so we know what it's like to try to get every stroke in before it's over. But you think that you're too good for your chick, even though this is your past history.
Well, I don't do it now. I was 22. But I was 22. I didn't have a chick at the time.
I was married with kids, so 22. Not fucking a blow-up doll.
Well,
even the doll tried to get out of it.
Sure.
By Hari Kari.
Tried to kill itself.
She couldn't. I banged her good, baby.
Did you name her first?
Yeah, Felicia. What's wrong with that? It's kind of a black-sounding name. I bought a Vivica Fox look-alike.
Bob, you're on Manifest.
Hey, 12145.
I'm not going to bother. It's still in the other bank. Go ahead.
Anyway, I was wondering where Dave refers to the mean street of Belmar and then the spoiled streets of Spring Lake. I never heard of his band. I live in Belmar all my life.
Well, you didn't go to the proper coffee shop, sir. You missed it.
The proper coffee shop?
Uh-huh.
I've lived there for 47 years. I know everything that goes. It's a 1 square mile town.
You're probably... This is the only concert ever took place at the Starbucks. People were still talking about it.
I'm telling you.
There's no Starbucks. There was only one coffee house.
You know, I...
Blue Moon Coffee House, right?
Before I came in today. Do you know the place?
Not there anymore now.
Yeah.
I know, but when it was there, we blew the fucking roof off the place. Guys with ears shut it down.
Oh, okay.
You missed it.
People
were throwing creamers. They were so excited. He probably missed Woodstock. He missed all the good things.
Yeah. Okay. I just had no idea. Never heard of your band, so I just had to call and tell you that. All right.
Peace. You know, I had on the Rachel Ray program when I'm fucking getting ready to come in here today. And she's like, oh, here's some band making their national debut. And they're fucking playing, and the guy's hideous. And, like, he's like 45, 50 years old. And I'm like, this is odd for someone to get a break at this fucking age. And the drummer looks like he's 57. And there's backup singers, the broads in the 50s. I'm like, you never see this. I go, it's some fucking gimmick. It's her husband. Now, all of a sudden, this guy who's good enough to fucking do what the rest of us are afraid to do, eat Rachel Ray pussy, he gets rewarded by putting his fucking garage band that started in 77 on the fucking national TV.
That's not fair.
No.
Put guys with ears. We're still around, my buddy Pat. He still plays the meanest bass you ever heard.
Wait, where did you turn stupid and black?
I was trying to make it sound more rock and rollish.
Who would you say you guys sounded like?
I would say a
men with hats.
No, I would say a mixture of the Stones, Stone Temple Pilots, Warren Zevon, and Led Zeppelin. Or like the four bands. What?
The four covers you did?
We happened to
All right,
do
boys,
Werewolf.
We're doing Werewolves of London. Let's take this baby home.
But you should have heard.
Thanks, coffee shop. Are you enjoying yourself? No. Just grabbing some coffee, going back to work.
It was great, man. I wish my friend Pat would call in.
Well, let's see if he does. This would be exciting.
Pat? Oh,
nothing. What was the big covers that you did?
We did Werewolves in London. Mm-hmm. We did Mr. Brownstone, ironically. We did, Knocking on Heaven's Door. That was like that just was unbelievable how great. And for that one, Mr. B, I came from behind the drum set, and we had a guy who played drums with us for one song, because I had to give the crowd the frontman experience, you know. And I
did you guys
axel.
Ever get a pan gig?
I did the axel. No, we didn't get any money.
How many gigs did you do altogether?
I don't know. I mean, I would say like 10 gigs. And I mean, we played high school because we were in high school. We played Battle of Bands. We won one of them. We did win one of them.
Was there another band?
There was four other bands. And we were the number one band of the Hot 5 Jersey Shore Rock Experience.
There was four bands in the Hot 5?
Five bands, and we beat those other four bands of pussies. We beat them like a pulp.
Huh?
Like a dog pulp.
Just words.
Ron and Fez Show.
It's the Ron and Fez Show on XM 202.
That girl fell in love with a pretty girl named Lily. With a pretty girl named Lily. That girl fell in love with a pretty girl named Lily. With a pretty girl named Lily. Even though he knew he didn't deserve one, Earl was shocked to find out he didn't get a raise. Wiki sent him on his way. Hold up, hang on, it gets a little sadder. The lone wolf has been shattered. Lily fell in love with somebody else. How will black girl live with himself? Watch it slip through your fingers. She don't love black girl because he's black. Looks like someone else is moving in on the girl of your dreams. It's only a matter of time before black girl loses his mind. Dry your eyes, sweet savage.
Take it easy, black girl.
Earl's wheels spinning. Rock and Fez got it going on all night long.
White people are so afraid of black people.
Take it easy.
So cute. When I hear a song about the Romeo and Juliet of the Ron and Fez show, it just it means a lot to me. All right, 866-RON-0-FEZ, 866-RON-0-FEZ. Was that first break 2 hours?
Almost, yeah.
Wow. This show flies without Fez. I never realized it before, but he really does have a tendency to slow things down.
Well, I mean, yeah.
He's great and all. But when we don't have anyone crying, everyone seems to be in a better mood going along.
Trembling. Fears. I'm afraid of the bridge this time. I'm afraid of the tram this time.
You know, I never noticed, but that is a really great impression that you do. When you shake your shoulders back and forth and you put your hands out.
They don't see it at home, but trust me, the arms look exactly like
him. It's always T-Rex arms with him. And then I like the fact that you did it like one of those hip-hop poets where, I'm afraid of the bridge this time. I'm afraid of the tram this time. Young, black, and American. Why do all your poets, your Def Jam poets, talk the same way, Earl?
I don't know. It's just like a whole delivery scheme that they have to work out. Like, it's like, remember, you got to flow it like this and keep it going and make everything dramatic.
This is me, 22 years old, black, proud of myself, proud of my heritage, proud of my ancestors. Just stop talking that way. You don't anyway. Has anyone ever had like a spoken word album that sold at all? I know a lot of people have tried them, but I don't think that any of them ever really did decent.
I mean, was it King Missile, maybe?
Oh, yeah, King Missile was my all-time favorite. I forgot about those guys. But, yeah, it is a tough thing to pull off. And then what are you supposed to, like, you can't even be there on the album cover doing what, holding a piece of paper that you're reading off of? You don't have a lot of props there.
I hate when bands have to put themselves on a cover of an album as if we don't know what we're buying. Like, you too. We get it. You're a fucking legendary band. You don't need to be on your last 3 or 4 or 5 covers. Get over yourselves already. You're in the spotlight enough.
It's kind of an interesting thing. Do you think it sells more, Earl?
It sells more, Dave, because, like, what's it, Oprah Magazine? She puts herself on the cover and it sells more. It's just a marketing thing. If you see Bono anywhere on anything, more people will stop as opposed to, let's say, like a picture
There's
of a building.
Tree.
Yeah.
Joshua tree.
Because Pink Floyd's best-selling album just has a picture of a triangle and a rainbow coming out of it. No picture of the
prism.
Band.
It's not a triangle and a rainbow. It's a prism.
Well, whatever it is, it's not the band. They don't need to be seen.
Now, I got to kind of agree with him there, Earl, that maybe is the coolest, simplest album cover of all time.
Yeah, but I mean, think about the Beatles. The Beatles put themselves on the cover all the time. Why? Because if
what about the White Album? That shit was white, and it still fucking went platinum.
No, but in the days of early days of Beatlemania, if you stuck their faces on it, you know, girls are going to instantly go out and buy that record.
That's why the White Album's the coolest cover, because we don't need to see Paul with his stupid boy band grin. Even though I'm a
Thank
Paul
you.
Fan, yeah. I'm just saying, with physical appearances, it's obnoxious. Even a cool guy like Beck puts himself on the cover too much.
He's a Scientologist. Todd, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, what about Jim Morrison, American poet?
Well, that was after he died, so I don't know how that sold. And then they also threw in Roadhouse on the song.
Yeah.
So another really great live version of that. Chris, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, boys. I just want to point out that Henry Rollins sold a lot of spoken word albums and stuff.
Yeah, I know he did, but I don't think he probably sold as much as his other stuff. Wes, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, how's it going, Ron? I wanted to let you guys thank Allen Ginsberg, The Line for Real, that spoken word album sold actually pretty well.
Yeah, I don't think it ever went gold, though, because I went to see Ginsberg talk. And